with a lot of high-profile celebrities, right?
Don't make me go on and on about myself like some sort of dickhead. I want to talk with you, not at you.
Oh, come on. Pretty please? With sugar on top? You must have been in some incredibly dangerous situations, right? Shootouts and hostage negotiations, like in movies.
You still trying to drag my secrets out, Annie? You're persistent. I might have to keep an eye out.
Flatterer.
You're gonna be trouble for me, I can just tell.
Didn't you say something about a sheikh before? What was he like? Did you fall for one of his beautiful daughters?
I should get back to...
Put a pin in it, yeah.
Right, yeah.
Sorry.
Yes, actually, could you speed up time so I don't die from boredom and fear? I may have to fight the fight. I said speed up time, not my passing.
Now just go away, will you?
Of course, sir. I'll come back later.
How very kind of you, dear Mr. Fugsby. I hope to see you soon.
Creepy old git.
Top of things, Elaine.
Sure am, Mr. Fernsby. Coming along just fine.
I trust Mr. Patrick is not interfering with work. We need everything ready for tomorrow.
He's just bored, I think. I can work while we talk.
Just need to have talking, Dr. Elaine. Mr. Patrick is not acquainted with how things are done here.
I'm fine. Thanks for checking in.
May I get you anything, Mr. Patrick?
Privacy. Maybe still keeping an eye on. Who put you up?
Did the portrait photographer check out? You verified his identity?
I vetted him thoroughly. He's good.
That is the door to Rebecca's room. Thank you. I can see from the log that... Rebecca was in a conference call from 9 p.m. to midnight last night.
Hey, you! You're trespassing! In case you didn't hear me. Enough! Stop!
Sir, you're free to move on now.
Thank you.
Thank you. Well?
Well, what did you find?
I'm really sorry, sir. Unfortunately, I'm not allowed to let you pass. Orders, you... No. Asshole. You'll never come through here as long as I'm alive. Now get the fuck out of my face. As I said, I'm really sorry.
Even if you are the prettiest girl I met in years.
Well, I'm just saying.
Oh, you're being so coy. Okay, sure. We should get back to it. Yeah.
I should probably... Right. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Reading? You look reading.
I do like reading.
I read too.
An old letter, 47. Never opened. Must have slid under the secret door nearly 46 years ago. It states that Alexa Carlyle's older brother, Montgomery, wanted Alexa to become the heir to the Carlyle Empire instead of himself. Interesting. You're an excellent detective, 47. Uncovering truths half a century old. If you frame it correctly, I believe you could use the information to convince Madame Carlyle that Zachary committed suicide. Maybe you should ask Mr. Fernsby to see her. Or perhaps you feel like digging a bit more.
Rebecca.
Just run through his plan for 3 seasons yesterday.
broken lab equipment. It looks like it was recently used. Though.
This is a table showing lethal dosages for the poison used to kill Zachary.
Something is circled 47. Female, age 65 to 79, 60 to 64 kilograms. I'd say Madame Carlyle is next in line for a poisoning. You have uncovered enough evidence to tell Madame Carlyle that Emma is the murderer. Quite the detective, 47. I'm impressed. I suggest you go tell Mr. Fernsby.
Yeah, keep it real.
I am ready to present my conclusion to Madame Carlyle.
Very well. If you'll follow me, sir. This is Madame Carlyle's office. Please step inside.
Detective skills have gained you access to the Lion's Den, 47. Now, go claim your reward.
So, Mr. Whitmer, you've reached a conclusion. Take a seat. Please, go ahead.
Your niece, Emmer Carlyle, murdered your brother Zachary.
My niece? Emmer is not my niece. She's my daughter-in-law.
And your niece. Emmer is the illegitimate child of your late older brother, Montgomery, who you and Zachary killed 46 years ago.
That's preposterous.
You asked me to find out what happened to Zachary. Would you rather not know?
No. No, go on.
I found a letter from Emmer's mother, Jane, who was the fiancé of your older brother at the time of his death. She witnessed how you and Zachary pushed him off the balcony. She believed you did it to steal the Carlyle Empire from her and her unborn child. And she raised Emmer to reclaim what she lost, marry your heir, Gregory, get revenge, and secure the Carlyle Empire for her bloodline generations to come.
Emma is the daughter of Montgomery and that local girl, Jane.
She is.
Well, the girl got it wrong. I didn't steal anything. I did what was necessary to protect the future of the Carlyles. Montgomery wasn't cut out to take over from father, all heart and no balls.
Emma used the funeral gathering to speed up her installment as the lady of the house, seizing the opportunity to stage Zachary's suicide. She did her homework, used a poison made from one of Zachary's rare plants, found old floor plans from Thornbridge Manor to gain access to his room through a secret passage.
That scheming bitch.
More than you think. I found proof that she will try to poison you next.
Well, I'll have to take care of that. Thank you, Mr. Whitmer. You have not disappointed. I promised you I would reward you generously if you solved the case. So, what do you suggest?
I want the file you have on Arthur Edwards.
Edwards, the Constant. But how do you... Oh, I see. I expected you might show up. But to kill me, not help me. But I've been wrong on so many things lately, so why not this one? I will give you the file on Edwards. You've earned it. I don't suppose I could convince you to deal with my daughter-in-law now you're here. I would like to see her dead. No? What a shame. I'll have to see to it some other way then. All you want is in the safe. God, I hope you get Edwards and make him hurt. I need some privacy. Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Good work, 47. That's the file on Arthur Edwards secured. Time to take care of Madame Carlyle.
What was that?
Mission complete. Well done, 47.
Ah, cool. How are you today, sir?
Seven. They're everywhere. Go, get out! It's the Constantine! Shit!
Stay down. Boss wants you alive.
Yeah?
How about now?
Over here! Cover me!
Walk away!
Or what? You gonna take us all on?
Don't.
Tell the Constant to start running!
You think you've won? 47 is out there. And 47 never misses his mark.
Neither do you, Miss Burnwood. That's what makes you valuable.
You're delusional. You think I would betray 47?
Trust me. You owe him nothing.
What is this?
I told you we could help each other. And I meant it. I look forward to your call.
Gray is gone. Go to Berlin and stay out of sight. We're all that's left now.